now to a WPBF 25 News exclusive. A man caught on camera touching a young girl and accused of molesting others faces sentencing tomorrow. The mother of one of the girls says that man might never have gone to jail had it not been for a WPBF 25 News investigation last summer. Investigative reporter Terry Parker has more on this story. Terry?
That's right. A man with a lengthy history, a prime suspect in a child's rape, almost given a plea deal until we investigated.
I think he is very dangerous. I really think that if he was out, your kids, your little girls wouldn't be safe.
Holly Stripoli says she's enormously relieved. Jackie Wheeler, caught on camera groping little girls in 2012, who almost walked away from other molestation charges last year with no jail time, now faces up to 11 years in prison, labeled a sexual offender for life.
It makes us feel good that finally he's getting what he deserves, and he won't be able to do anything to any little girls ever again.
Last August, Stripoli called WPBF 25 News in a panic. She just learned the state attorney's office was offering a plea deal to Wheeler with minimal jail time, even though Wheeler was accused of molesting Stripoli's 15-year-old relative.
They said all of a sudden that they didn't have a strong enough case.
That despite Wheeler already being on probation for groping little girls in supermarkets. And then I uncovered some even more stunning news. The man being offered this lenient plea deal was the prime suspect in the rape of a 10-year-old Martin County girl. Here's what the sheriff told me then.
Mr. Wheeler is a prime suspect in our case, and nothing we've done so far has eliminated him from being our prime suspect.
Once we started questioning the plea deal that was going to let Wheeler go free with time served, the St. Lucie County State Attorney's Office suddenly rescinded it. And now, a year later, prosecutors have hammered out a much stiffer deal, and Wheeler will be sentenced Friday to prison.
I called you, and then when they found out that, you know, you were calling, that's when they figured, you know, they want something done, that we were serious.
That sentencing takes place tomorrow morning at the St. Lucie County Courthouse, and mothers of at least two victims plan to be there in the courtroom and see what they call justice served. Terry Parker, WPBF 25 News. Terry.